could never be what I am. But as long as he with me, that's what it's gon' be.
What's up, y'all? So I said I was gonna be getting back on YouTube too. So I'm here with another video. This video is gonna be about how birth control almost killed your girl. Alright. So last time I was on YouTube, I was giving birth to her. Now she is 10 months old, she is walking, and she is about to be one. Alright, this is my baby girl, Amira Tanae Brown. Yeah, so since the last video, I have bought a house, I have a baby, my oldest daughter has turned 2, and I am now out of the military and working from home. So that's just a little update about my life, but that's not what we're here to talk about. So I got on birth control at the age of 15 or 16, I want to say, because my grandparents suggested birth control after I had gotten pregnant at 15 and I had an abortion and I did not want to get pregnant again. So first birth control I was ever on was the Nexplanon, which is the one that goes in the arm. I don't know if you can see the mark on my arm from where I had it at, but yeah. So with the Nexplanon, I bled for 7 to 8 months straight, every single day. Heavy bleeding, not light spotting, heavy bleeding. I lost so much blood that I was losing weight. I was in and out of the doctor's office. I even had to go to the hospital. I was losing so much blood. It was ridiculous. Passing out, like, I just didn't know what was going on. So after I got off of the Nexplanon, I got the Depo shot. Depo shot had in my arm. So when I got the Depo shot, I was good for like 2 weeks, no bleeding. I just thought I was cool. Boom, bleeding again for another 3 to 4 months. So I'm just like, what is going on? I just didn't understand. Like, maybe it was the birth control, maybe it was my body. Still no way for me to understand whichever one it was. Still don't care. So while I was on Depo, I took a bath one night, and while I was in the bathtub, bleeding, just bleeding like crazy, sitting in the bathtub, damn near passed the fuck out. And I'm like, what the hell? I had to go to the hospital because I was losing blood. Pints and pints and pints of blood. A doctor said they have never seen somebody on birth control bleed so much that they are losing weight. Birth control is dangerous. That shit is not good for you. And I would never get back on it. I don't care. I don't care about trying to prevent pregnancy. I don't care about none of that. My mental health and my physical health is more important to me than trying to prevent from having a baby. Plus, I'm married, so who cares? Like, I love kids, so having kids does not bother me. After I got off the Depo, I was on nothing. I wasn't having sex, so I didn't worry about it. I did start having sex at a young age. I lost my virginity at 15. And after I lost my virginity, I got pregnant. The first time I had sex, I got pregnant. So, yeah, I thought birth control was going to be the answer because that was not supposed to happen. But, yeah, I would never get back on birth control. After birth control, after the Depo shot birth control, I was on pills, taking the pills. The pills made me moody, suicidal, all of that. Birth control is a killer. It is a secret killer. I don't care what nobody says. I don't care how much it prevents pregnancy. I don't care how it makes nobody else feel. That shit did not make me feel good. So, no, it's cut. I don't care. So, now it's just, I'm not on any type of birth control right now. And I don't plan on ever getting back on birth control because of the things that I went through while I was on it. It was just sickening. Like, and then I was young too, so I was just like, what in the world? And if you can't see, and you look at me, I'm already small. I'm already small as it is. So it's not like I need to keep losing blood so I can keep losing weight, as if I'm not little enough already. Like, yeah. let me see, I'll go back to work. So I'm gonna finish this video when I get off.
All right, I'm back. But for real, after I got off the depot, I started taking the pills. The pills like have my libido like super low. My sex drive was low. Even though I wasn't having sex, it was low. It's like it had dried my, you know, vagina out. It was just terrible. Like, I've had nothing but bad experiences with birth control. But the Nexplanon is really what almost took me out of here. Like, I lost so much blood. It's ridiculous. I didn't even know it was possible to lose so much blood that you were losing weight. My iron was low. I'm anemic, so that's not making it any better. It's just ridiculous. I would not suggest anybody get on birth control, but you know, that's just me. I mean, what doesn't work for me may work for others. What doesn't work for others may work for me. Birth control does not work for me. I don't care. I really don't care. Yes, I have two kids. As of right now, I do not want any more. But that does not mean that I'm about to get on birth control. I'm not even about to play with my life like that. It's crazy because doctors, after you have babies, they try to push birth control on you so much. Like, you be like, you don't want it, you don't want it, you don't want it. And they still be like, well, you should get on it. You should try this one. You should try that one. And the crazy part is, after I had Amira, I was supposed to get birth control. I was supposed to get the IUD put into, you know, my vagina. So that would be my birth control. But they did not do it. So I was like, I'm not getting it done. Because if I wanted it done, I wanted it to be done while I was still numb from the epidural and I couldn't feel it. But because they forgot, nope, cancel it. It's crazy though. Because I hear about a lot of people that like have good experiences with birth control, and I just wish that it would have been the same for me. But it's just not, and I just rather keep myself protected. I just don't think it's worth it. I don't think it's for the body. As a postpartum depression is not enough. Birth control brings depression and bad hormones and a mix of everything. It's just ridiculous. And that is what a lot of doctors will not tell you. A lot of doctors will not tell you that you'll lose weight, or they will not tell you that you'll gain weight, or that you'll be depressed, or that you'll lose so much blood. They're gonna talk it up to make it sound good so you can get on it. And then when you start having problems, as soon as you go back to the doctor, they're gonna start acting clueless, like they ain't know what's going on. Baby know what's going on. But yeah, this is a really short story time. Y'all gonna have to give me more ideas on story times to do, because this one was not that long. But you know, first video I'd have made into first video I'd have made in 10 months. Hope y'all enjoyed it. I'll catch y'all next time. Drop some story time ideas in the comments, some question and answers, some pranks, shoot, I don't know. Drop something. I feel like I'm chosen, I'm covered in gold.